Now that we have seen what a relational database looks like, we said it's a collection of relations or tables, and we looked at a table, tuples in it, the various attributes and so on. So what kind of operations can you perform on tables? Of course, you can create a table. We're talking about selecting certain information out of a table of relations. So for example, I can say everybody who is in a certain department, we can read that information out of that relation. That's what a query selection we do, and we're going to see examples of that would return us. You can select information. You can, of course, insert tuples or rows. You can update attribute values that are in there. You can actually perform join operations across multiple tables. And of course, you can delete tuples, delete tables, and eventually delete a database. That may be a collection of tables. You know, create, delete are sort of similar to what we have seen before, for example, files. But some of the things like select, insert, join, these are kind of new to how you can manipulate and access data that is stored in a database. What I do for, we said we write queries or programs to access data that is stored in a database, and those programs or queries can actually make use of these operations that we're talking about. So this is saying select star means everything, so all attribute values, from the employee table that we had where the department ID is 15. So we are saying basically tell us, give us the information about every employee who works in department that has ID 15. So this is an example of how I might access information that is stored in the relation or the table that we just saw. And this is an example of a read query, because all we're doing is reading selected pieces of information that is there in that table and returning that to whoever is making this request. So actually, if you're going to run this query against the table that we just saw, you'll see that the department ID is 15 for two employees, Robin and Cody. So we're going to get the tuples for Robin and Cody in response to when we run this query against the database that we have. So selection has happened because, of course, we had a lot more employees. Now we're only selecting the ones who work in the department with ID 15, who happen to be these two people. And these are written, or the programs or queries are written in a language, a query language. We talked about SQL before, and we'll see some more examples of that. But basically, these programs or queries that we're talking about in this language allow you to use these basic operations that you can perform on tables or relations. And you can use these operations in the programs that you write or the queries that you submit to access the data that is of interest to you.